desperate quest to overcome the final hurdle, sex change surgery. Once achieved, the operation is shown in graphic detail.
It's 1980, and George Roberts has lived for almost a year as Julia and is desperate for sex change surgery. To obtain the operation, Julia has to win the approval of a specialist psychiatrist. He's wary of Julia and her previously flamboyant life on the gay scene. Frustrated by the lack of progress, she sought private treatment for breast implants without the psychiatrist's approval. Julia and boyfriend Armour wonder how much longer the psychiatrist will keep her waiting for the surgery to complete the sex change.
On my way down to Hove to see the doctor. It's 10 days now since I've had surgery, and I feel I haven't actually seen the breasts without the bra on, so it's going to be an important day, an unveiling day for me, and I'll be able to feel what it feels like without the bra.
And the scars were checked by the doctor to see if the actual operation had taken. It wasn't as I actually sat up, but I realised I had a lot more than it looked.
Yes. Swing round and face me.
One of the side effects of the hormone tablets is you put on weight.
That's fine. Right consistency.
Those scars shouldn't show in 3 months. I still don't want you to raise your arms above your head except just a short while doing your hair. And certainly no squash, swimming or badminton or anything like that till I see you again in a month.
Fine.
If you have any problems, let me know at once, fair enough. If you think you're running a temperature, if you've got any aching pain or anything, just pick up the telephone and let us know.
Fine, yes.
Don't suffer in silence.
Hello.
Hello, my love.
Got everything packed? Oh, no, you haven't got...
No, don't fuss.
Having Armour around has made life much easier for me, and now I've experienced actually living over as a woman for a year. It seems far more urgent that I get it all finished.
I've never told you anything but the truth.
You've hardly told me anything at all. All you are really good for is 10% of the action of this place.
Mr. Pollard, this is a good proposition, and I can make it work.
I put on high heels for the first time, and the weight of pulling your back on high heels anyway, it's like putting a bra on with 2 pounds of sugar in each bra and sort of drop forward, and you have to really lift to keep sort of the bust upright. That was a bit painful, but it was a good sensation because when I walked, the bust moved. Although it was still a little bit hard, it moved sort of normally. It's like waking up out of a nightmare. You suddenly, part of it's done.
Thank you.
Well, it's exactly a year since I came to see at the hospital for the first time. This should be the next to last interview. Next time I should be able to find out whether I get the operation or not on National Health, or whether I'm paying for it. I don't know what the reaction is going to be this time, but I've had that bust done to prove that I want to do something permanent, and we'll just have to see what his reaction is.
Come in.
Right, it's done there, isn't it?
been happening to you since I saw you last?
Well, since I last saw you, I've had the bust operation done.
And who arranged that?
I saw my GP because my tablets were having a side effect. My hair was getting very, very thin. And I was getting a little bit of pain in the bust. And I went to see a doctor, or a surgeon in Hove, who examined me. And I had the operation about 10 days after seeing him. And paid for that.
I found it difficult to believe that the GP would do it without referring to me. And what is more, female hormones make male hair better, not worse.
Well, I found my hair was getting very thin and straggly.
Say as you like.
Whether it was the way I was washing it, I don't know.
And how much did it cost you?
$720.
Where did you get that from?
There's money that I've earned while working.
I'd find it difficult to find £720 for a cosmetic operation between July and when you were last unemployed and January.
Well, I had help from the guy I live with. I have no living expenses at the moment.
Well, I should be writing to your GP to find out why he did it without consulting me. Because I'm supposed to be directing your case, because it's primarily a psychiatric matter. And I must confess I take exception to your doing that.
Well, I thought it was something permanent. I needed something to establish that I was doing what I was doing.
It's a medical matter. It isn't a personal choice. I like to be informed. See, once again, you're overstepping the mark, and I don't like it one bit. If I am supposed to be directing your total medical affairs, then I like to know about such things.
So well, I found that everything is taking, because it's taking such a long time, I found that there was a need, because I was so reaching a level where I was having trouble with the relationship with the guy I'm still living with.
Yes, but your need is not paramount. What matters is that things should be done properly and medically.
Well, I think it was done medically. I think the surgeon was quite ethical about it all.
I should write to your GP and find out exactly how it came about.
I was just in a position where I thought it was better to keep things moving.
You didn't? Yes, I knew.
Yeah, it was a case where I had nearly a year of tablets. There was hardly any change. I wanted to prove that I'm sincere about having the operation. So by having something done which is permanent, it proves that I'm partway there. Or it helps me to accept the fact that I'm halfway there.
You may think that. I don't know if I share your view. However, I shall have to speak to my surgeon to see what his view of the matter is. But in any case, you have not yet been living for 1 year as a male. No,
five weeks to go.
5 weeks to go?
4 or 5 weeks, yes.
I first saw you
4th of January, and I changed over on the 3rd of March.
Well, maybe. I don't wish to appear to be petulant, but really, you're not arranging this affair in a manner that fits our protocol. We have a long experience of dealing with people who want this sort of thing done, and we like to do it in our way. Then we know what's going on. But I don't like people who step out of line. I find that it's, to say the very least, irritating.
Well, so because there are such big gaps between sort of interviews, so with you
I would point out that the interview times were arranged by us for September and you didn't come after July. And you missed that appointment.
But from this last appointment to this one, so the 8 to 12 week period, it's...
That's often enough. I see my patients once every 10 to 12 weeks. When they're waiting for things to be done or to put in time towards qualifying for surgery. Surgery will be undertaken, if it is undertaken, by paying for it privately, just as you might buy a motor car, or going on the National Health Service waiting list, which is now about 2.5 years. But I warn you, if any attempt to manipulate it will results in my discharging you from my clinic as a patient.
If somebody was to go as a private patient, how long could they expect to wait? Is there an approximate period?
It depends on the availability of a suitable bed and a suitable clinic. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to bargain with you as to when it's to be done. No decision has been made to do
well,
it
I'm finding having difficulties with a guy I'm living with.
So do many of my patients with their associates. Why should you be different?
It's just something that I know I have the finance now to pay for it, and I'd rather get it over with as soon as possible.
Well, having the finance doesn't mean to say that anybody will do it because you have the money. I want to make that point quite clear.
Right.
I don't think you conducted yourself particularly tactfully in all this. And there I think the interview will end. Thank you very much. You'd better come and see me in another 3 months.
Six weeks' time, not 12 weeks, as he said, because I've done my year, as he stipulated in the first place. And if he refuses to see me, then I'll go elsewhere. He's just playing cat and mouse. He says he's being ethical. I think he's being very unethical in his ways. I am not an animal, and I'm being treated like I'm an animal. So, I'll leave it at that. You know, a psychiatrist can't sit there and say that in an hour, over a sort of a year's period, he knows me, because that is rubbish. He sees a visual thing, and I could go and sit and tell him any cock and bull story. If I thought I could go and sit there and sort of say, well, yes, I'm working, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, and I was going to get the operation for being a good girl. No, you can do that. No, and I fought back. And I said, well, why not? And why can't I have the operation? And what I'll shout back is, at 16 I can go and fight for my country, and at 25 I can't make my decision about my own body, and it is my body.
One chicken sandwich, please.
I work in a club in the evenings, which is 6 nights a week, and I have to work from 9 till 4 in the morning. Well, following the last interview with my psychiatrist, where I had the argument about my bust operation, I began making inquiries about private treatment. My job in the club wouldn't have paid for that, so I had to look for alternative ways of making money.
The act itself is very simple. A lot of people don't realise this. An act is composed of a beginning, an end, and a middle. And the first thing you've got to do is to create interest. And that's why I think a sort of number like Love for Sale.
I'm
exaggerating to make the point. You mentally take them individually. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Love for Sale, the story that it tells, of the lonely cop on the beat. I can't remember the actual lyrics, but that sort of thing. Yeah, what stuff do you like to sing?
Things like the sexiest girl in town, and Mama thinks I'm working in a convent. It's not dirty. But it goes over well.
Yes, it's but you can't compose a whole act.
Oh, no.
It's like having a meal of meringues and trifle every meal. There's got to be light and shade in an act, otherwise the act is of no value. So I think that the things that we have to talk about are, one, the type of costume, because that gives the feel of what you want to do.
Colours and material that are being used.
No, they're nice. I'm a little bit worried about that, but because I feel that that's a hard colour. Go to something more a lemon.
I don't suit lemon. I suit red. I look good in red.
As a drag act.
Well, I look good in red as a woman.
Okay, but I find that these colours are very, very heavy. It's too leery, you see, and you've got to think of it in a softer feel. It's too hard. You don't need to be larger than life. You're the exception to that rule. because you are larger than life. Don't. Are you with me?
Yeah.
I don't mean physically, but you're going to explode on the stage. You'll have a very, very good act. You'll be nicely dressed, but don't come out and poke their eyes out. All right, then. Now, would you like to stand up so I can take some shots of you?
I don't want the legs.
No, I just want to take one. That's not a bad idea. Do you want to film this, dear? Can you just get over that corner there? Right. Now, I'll tell you what I'd like you to do, if it's at all possible. Can you stand back a bit? And can you just lift your skirt up? I just want to... That's right.
You watch it.
Sorry, Ben.
Not better that way, I'll have side on. Oh, I'm getting on the wall. After my last interview with the doctor, where there's a little bit of a friction because I'd had the bust surgery done, the psychiatrist sent me a letter saying that if I didn't tell him who had referred me for surgery, then... within a fortnight, then he refused to treat me. It was a catch-22. He wasn't prepared to accept the fact that I'd had a bust operation without his consent. And his actual words on the last interview that he didn't know whether his surgeon would do the main surgery because I'd had the bust surgery done first. I'm now getting desperate and I've considered going to Casablanca for the operation, where I can obtain it on demand. But both Alma and I are worried. It's a little bit risky. The operation may not be a success if I go over there. Because I've fallen out with my original psychiatrist, my only way forward was to contact somebody privately. And all the phone calls have led me to a surgeon who's at least agreed to meet me.
Julia, tell me in your own words, what is it that you actually want?
Well, I've gone to the stage where I've performed what has been asked of me as living over as a woman for the year's period. I now feel I want to actually get the main surgery over and have what I consider to be something that I don't want, sort of taken away.
But how long have you felt like that?
Well, I first saw, or made an appointment to see a doctor 10 years ago, but nothing came of that, and so since then I've had an inner struggle. Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you appreciate that any sort of surgery in that area is relatively major, and that there can be problems that can occur. Fortunately, they don't usually happen, and most people get on all right. But it'd be jolly painful for a day or two afterwards, and I'm sure they've told you.
I don't care if it went on for a month, yes. Because when it's over, yeah. it's over.
Yes. Are there any questions you'd like to ask me at all?
Well, things about the actual surgery. So the later operations I've seen have had the sort of lips developed and the clitoris developed. Mm-hmm. One thing that does worry me is depth, mm-hmm. of how deep the vagina, mm-hmm. would be. Mm-hmm. Because I think that would play a big role in satisfying my partner.
Sure. Well, to answer those questions, the depth, first of all, would be around 6 inches, about somewhere between 14 and 18 centimetres. To some extent, it depends upon your anatomy. And as well as that, the width would probably be about 2 inches or so. As far as a clitoris is concerned, this can be moulded. It's not going to be the same as a female clitoris would be in a normal born female, but something can be developed there which will have sensation and will look the part. You mentioned the sort of folds at the side, the labia. They can also be constructed and will be hair-bearing, whereas the actual cavity of the vagina won't be hair-bearing, except just at the outlet. Mm. I don't think it's very easy to get mucus-secreting glands in the area, although it may be possible.
That's lubrication.
Type thing. It may be possible, but again, a lot of the problems depend on what seems feasible when one's there. Mm-hmm. Well, Julia, you know that I want you to see a psychiatrist about this, and that if he agrees and thinks this is reasonable, then I would be happy to go ahead and perform the surgery for you. But, of course, the final decision must be yours.
I don't know whether I'm any further forward. Will the surgeon psychiatrist say no, or will he be prejudiced by my sort of previous meetings with the first psychiatrist? That Coronation Street, isn't it? The whole view is amazing. Back to that. I'm on my way down to see my family for the first time. It's the first time they'll actually see me as a woman. I've just come into the end of my first year, so I feel more confident now sort of going there and sort of see them and sort of show them what the changes have been. So I'm just hoping the reception is good.
Your mother's in women's lib, you know.
Yours is dropped. I just had them put up.
You're okay, love.
Yeah.
I miss you, Tilly. It's all takes a minute, isn't it?
Yeah. You got my lipstick on your face.
Well, that doesn't matter. You wipe it off, Dan.
It's off, it's all right.
I've saved that, and every time I've looked at it,
oh, that's my engagement ring, that one.
Well, will you put that on your armpit? Give me one.
I wonder if we get it on.
Oh, Bev, give it me. My youngest daughter. My oldest daughter. And I've said a little prayer, and I've cried to it sometimes. But I want you to wear it for me. Where have you gone? Wear it. I know it's not a diamond. But I thought I was a little stone in the middle, and all the eight kids around me.
Oh, yeah. All right. She's come round. All right, come on.
She's as big as a mama.
Come on.
There you are. Let me take my coat off a minute. Sit down, we'll play. Nice looking woman.
Well, she checks after her mother.
She takes after her mother, don't you? Yeah. Of course you don't.
Hey, Jeff, you don't start me off.
Oh, no, hey, you keep away. That's
right,
you can't.
Keep your gums to you.
Johnny, run, then I would do.
Hey, you just suppose all that words and I want Johnny Margaret when you're jumping.
Where's your
own?
Yes. Listen, you can hide them up behind the smile, you know.
Oh.
Not where your mummy can. Don't part with it.
No, I'll keep it.
That's your engagement ring?
Yeah.
Oh, Shirley's got
I'm not
got
satisfied.
Mine.
I'll get the other bugger on
Shirley's
as well.
Shirley's got
get the wedding ring.
That's what they can do.
He looks after me.
I can't pronounce his name properly.
Oh, my.
Yeah. If he loves your pet like I love you, he'll be happy all
day. He's all right.
He's as ugly as what I am.
Huh?
Well, my fella's
they don't
got
many
a beard.
Ugly like
my
you.
Fella's got a beard.
They don't
and
make
a
many very ugly like you.
But I'll tell you what, Arden, if you picked a better one, didn't you? I mean, there's a comparison, isn't there?
Yes, isn't it? Have a look at it.
Always like Georgie best.
Oh, no, it's...
It's a bit bigger than Georgie.
Like George.
Oh,
no,
he is our Georgie best, though.
Lady, come.
Keep your eyes off him.
He likes
a blonde, busty woman.
And will you get married now?
Well, I can't get married legally. But
no.
I'll get married and stay down the court.
Well, live over the brush.
No, a sex change operation. I mean, they should say, like Julia was well, my son now, Julia's my daughter. I'm proud of her.
Why can't she get married? Why can't she adopt children even though she can't have them? She's got to be able to do these things. It's free. It's free life. Like a bird of the air, don't we? Everything's free.
Now I'm off to see my sisters, to see how they react. They've been quite nice about it all since I told them I was actually going to change my sex and become another sister. But I'm not quite sure how they're going to react now when they see me for the first time.
Where are you going?
Oh, 7, please.
Are you coming in?
See ya.
Thank
you very much. Hello.
God, they've got them
with me,
so all
right.
Yeah, come in.
Hello.
Who's
all this lot?
Oh,
some people saying they're... Huh? Hello. Some men like to be to get
hold of.
Excuse me.
Twice.
Hello.
How are you?
Hey? Hey, go.
Come on.
Oh, you start. I'll take your dummy.
So
thought you'd be a bra.
So that's pleasure to be back to
you. Well, no, when I lose weight, they'll look bigger. But the 40B now. I think it's the 40B cup.
I feel like I've been cheated.
So what,
you're
going to
slim yourself down?
Yeah, when the tablets were making me put on weight.
Yeah. Like
so,
the pill.
Huh?
Like the pill.
I put on weight on my stomach as well, not on my legs.
You're
not
doing
shit that. You've been dying to get a look at them legs, haven't you, for weeks? Swine. Well, when I went in, the reaction from my sisters was far different than I thought it would be. I thought that, you know, a lot of the hostility I had when the programme first went out would have rubbed off onto them, and apparently it hadn't. And I was lucky that my sister, who's been a bitch for years and we never ever spoke, was there and would be able to talk today. And I was just accepted. You know, I was classed as the auntie, you know, a new auntie to all the kids. And they never knew sort of Uncle George, so it's nothing to the kids. But I think it's really nice to be accepted like that. I'm now going to see the surgeon's psychiatrist, and it all depends on him whether or not I get the operation.
When did you first... how do you feel about sex now? Do you feel yourself as a...
I feel like a woman. I just feel trapped. As I am now, it's difficult because I've lived over as a woman for a year. So I feel like I should be normally. But when I first started, before I changed over, I felt trapped and unable to cope with life as it was as a male. Because there's a continual influence of a hidden female within me that couldn't come out. And now Julia has had a chance to come out for the last year and has been out. And George is completely forgotten, and anything that George did has gone. Did far more stage work as a female impersonator. For a while I survived just by sending women up. You know, if there were women in the audience, or the whole visual effect of a woman, I used to overdo everything. I'm looking back on that period of my life now, I think I was sending women up because I couldn't be a woman. I was frightened of being a woman.
How much feeling conviction is there in your concept of yourself as being a woman? Do you really feel very strongly?
Oh, yes.
Somebody
posed a question to me not long ago asking me what I would do if sex change surgery had never been discovered, knowing what I know now, that you know, people can change their sex. If it was suddenly stopped, I don't think I could go on as a male. I think I'd rather take an easy way out and just end it all. It just seems pointless. Because knowing the happiness I've had as a woman, living as a woman, means far more, and I'd rather go out like that rather than try to go out as a male.
This is a rather irreversible operation, isn't it?
I think I'm not making any mistakes. I've had 10 years of sort of turmoil and from sort of being near the 15 and sort of thinking, well, maybe the doctor can help me. And then having a struggle, and then in the last year, going through and meeting other transsexuals and finding so many that have had so much happiness by having the change.
Yes! Oh, my God, you've got a waist!
Jesus Christ!
Jeez. Oh, right.
That's got to come up.
I've got to lose 3 stone to keep it.
It's also got to come up an inch. Mm-hmm. Trap the skirt.
Fitting of my new stage clothes has been a bit of a squeeze. I'm going to have to go on a diet.
Does it need to be that high?
Just too large,
you know? Try it on the waist and see
what's happening. Where's it cut, there?
There. There, look.
Oh, yeah, sample.
Right, if I do that all the way around.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that.
Well, at last now I can celebrate. The psychiatrist has agreed and told the surgeon that he can go ahead with the operation, so I'm giving up work in the club. This is my last night, time to have a bop round with the lads while the armour carries on working. I've been through my ups and downs. You know, it's taken 18 months to get as far as this, and you know, I won't be feeling embarrassed anymore once it's all over. I'm going to be on an equal footing with everybody else.
Come on, love. Time to go home. Come on, we're closing. Take your tambourine. Come on, we want to lock the doors, my love. Come on, down. Don't you mind them stairs. Break your neck. You're pissed. Huh? I'm sober. Go on. Bye.
I hope you find it will be a good success.
Oh, I wish her all the luck in the world.
Sure,
for him.
It's a gizmo like this.
It's a very sort of unknown thing.
But her funny never be like mine.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
When I arrived, I was told I wasn't allowed to eat anything at all, so I was on foods only. And then they had the job of clearing me out or what had been there. So I had an enema, in the first place. And then I've had 3 or 4 bowel washes.
You seem very relaxed, considering that it's only an hour or so to go.
Well, it's not worth getting excited about, is it? It's, I've waited a long time for it, and for me, it's like it may have all been a dream for the last 10 years or whatever, and it's like coming out of a nightmare.
Well,
and it's only, you know, I know it's only an hour, 2 hours away, so it doesn't worry me.
Mr. Grant, this is your big moment. Do you mind going outside and putting the gown on? You know how it goes, don't you? And your hat. Miss Julia Grant. Miss Julia Grant, consent form.
And you have signed your consent form, right?
Your name. Pre-med is due at 11:30 a.m, which is scopolamine 20, on upon 20 milligrams scopolamine 0.4.
I'll start laughing.
That's fine. Okay, Julie, relax a little.
Just a small injection up here on your thigh.
All right. Mm.
Right into your muscle, it won't help.
Think of some nice things.
Jolly good.
I just thought
that's
of it.
Fine.
Super. Okay, Julie.
Okay.
Right.
Take your teeth out later on.
I will. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, well, that's it. Bye, Mum. Somebody could just steady that on, please.
Cool down on the draw sheet first, or...
Yes, okay, put them down on the draw sheet first.
The object of the operation is not just to remove the male genitalia, but to create a vagina that is as near as possible like a normal female vagina. This is done by utilizing the available skin both from the penis and also from the scrotum. And flaps of skin are planned using this dye as a marker.
That's what I thought, yes. That's what I'm having in mind. I think we can sort it, we can do it more.
After the flaps have been cut, then a cavity has to be created between the rectum at the back and the bladder at the front. The creation of this cavity is to some extent the key to the operation and will provide the space into which the skin will pass and so form a vaginal opening and cavity. The whole procedure cannot be hurried and has to be done meticulously.
I think what I'll do is I will remove it. I just want a 2-0 on a needle now, in a moment, Mary, rather. I think I'll just remove a bit more. What am I doing here?
The tube, which in a male is very long, is of course reduced in size and has to be brought out in an appropriate place on the skin flap.
Better get the lateral vessels in a minute, but whether we, in principle, bring those two halves together across the midline.
Clearly it's important to preserve the normal function of the bladder. The tube is placed in a normal position for a female so that the patient is able to pass urine satisfactorily.
I'm
the vaginal cavity will be lined by the skin flaps. Once the vaginal cavity has been made and the skin flaps inserted, then a large pack is inserted so as to preserve the cavity until healing has taken place. The operation has gone very well indeed, and there have been absolutely no problems from start to finish, and I don't anticipate any in the immediate post-operative period. Obviously, there can be complications, and we shall have Julia on a number of treatments, including antibacterial drugs, but I think everything will be all right. We've been able to create a very reasonable length vagina, and the urethra has been well placed, and I think everything went well.
See, she's not here today, eh? Oh. Okay.
Hello?
Julia? All finished. You're back in your bed now. Okay. Can you spit that out? Spit it right out. That's it. Right out. Lovely. Can you give us a little cough?
Can't.
That's it. It's all finished.
Hello. All right? That's marvellous. All finished and you're back in bed.
God.
Done very well.
That's splendid.
We'll leave you on your side for a little while, okay? As soon as it's possible, we'll turn you onto your back.
That's very nice.
Really?
So, come a little surprises. How are you feeling now?
Alright.
I'm glad it's all over now.
Hmm?
So I'm very glad it's all over.
Mm-hmm.
I was very worried yesterday. I was waiting for a phone call then. Then I came and I went out then and make a phone call. They said you're very, very well.
That's alright. Just a little bit of pain.
A little bit of pain.
I don't remember much about yesterday.
Oh well, you're alright. You look alright now.
Healthier in mind now.
You look much happier than before because everything's over and
just get over the next 2 or 3 days and everything will be okay.
I hope you'll recover very soon.
So do I. It's like working out of a bad dream.
When will you be able to say to get up and walk?
For 5 days to stay in bed. No food. No getting out of bed, no baths for 5 days.
Oh.
You're gonna be all right then.
So.
Well, it's been 10 days now since I've been in the clinic and had the operation. And although I'm still in quite a bit of pain, I've had to pad up because I've got to go home. I can't afford to stay on here indefinitely. Since I had the packing out last Monday, I've had to do dilating, which is an insertion into the actual operation to keep the hole that is there open, which is okay to do, but very painful after. But I've been given plenty of painkillers and things. Bye.
Oh, thank God, the journey home. First thing that people are going to ask me, you know, how did it feel like when you knew you'd had the operation, it was all finished? And when I think back to the actual first moments of coming round after surgery, it was really strange. I could see people stood in the room, and I understood that it was finished and over, but everything just didn't relate to what actually happened. Oh, my past life, none of it meant anything anymore. Yeah, you know, I was starting, bang, it was a whole new life. From that second on, I was sort of recreated, I've been redesigned, re-sculptured. For the first time, I was the person I was supposed to be, though I wasn't bits and pieces. The things that had happened sort of 2 or 3 years ago, which I thought were all relevant to me, just didn't seem to matter. And the whole last year that I've sort of, the traumas that I've had to get surgery, just didn't matter. There's no pretense anymore. Now I have the future to look forward to. Hopefully one day I'll be allowed to adopt children. Hopefully one day they'll allow me to marry. It's just society's got to accept me now.
Stories brought up to date next week at 9:30. It's 15 years since Julia made the change, so how is life now, and was it the right decision?
I've been far happier as I am now